Hello, my name is Mike, and I'm going to teach you how to improve your NPS surveys. It's been about a year since we released our native NPS fields with built-in reports, and they've been a huge success. But we want to make sure you're getting the most out of not just Formidable Forms, but what you build with it. So we have a few tips to improve those NPS surveys. Before I start though, I want to clarify that the goal is to improve the survey itself, not just the score. Making changes so that more of your promoters respond and your score increases does nothing to help your actual company. Remember Goodhart's law: when a measure becomes a target, it ceases to be a good measure. The goal should not necessarily be to increase your score, but to get better and more actionable results from your survey, so your company becomes more successful. Let's start with the questions. The default question when you drag and drop our NPS field is, how likely are you to recommend us to a friend or colleague? As a reminder, an NPS field is 0 to 10, with 9 and 10 being promoters, 7 and 8 passives, and 0 to 6 detractors. The question as it stands is solid and may not be worth changing. But if your product or service is more niche, you might want to consider changing it to something like, how likely are you to recommend us to someone like you? Maybe you wouldn't recommend the Rejuvenique mask to a friend because no one you know wants to look like Dwight when he cut off the face of a CPR dummy. But you would recommend it to a similar weirdo like you. So that's a better phrasing of the question. Do your best to never have more than 3 questions in your survey. 4 if you need a lead-in segmentation question because you offer various products or services. Why? Longer surveys drastically drop participation. And it's not an equal drop. Detractors and promoters are more likely to stick around than a passive. You'll have a much harder time figuring out what would motivate those to become promoters. Let's look at Formidable's default NPS survey template. It looks like way too many questions, right? Not quite. There are 2 lead-in questions, and I'd only recommend 1, so feel free to delete the one that is less helpful. Do you want what they're using? Or do you want to know what type of customer they are? After the NPS question, there are a lot of different open-ended questions, but you can see in the conditional logic on the left that they don't all show up. That depends on what their NPS answer is. What did they like if they're a promoter? What could we improve if they're a passive? And how did we disappoint you and what can we do to make it right if they're a detractor? And then we have 1 final follow-up question that's the same for all types. If you could have us add 1 feature to our services, what would it be? Again, this is a solid question. But what if you're not looking to expand your offerings? Instead, you want to know what brings people to your current offerings. Then a question like, what features do you value most, could be a better follow-up. Or you could use both with conditional logic, asking about new features to promoters and what do they value most to passives and detractors. And speaking of follow-up, do it. And not just a thank you for filling out this survey. Reach out to detractors after they fill this out. Offer a gift card if a passive is willing to get on the phone and further explain why their most valued feature is so important to them. Send a t-shirt to a promoter to tell you what they'll use that new feature they requested for. Remember, improving your NPS is secondary to improving your company as a whole. And that's how you can improve your NPS surveys. Subscribe for more Formidable Forms and form building tips, and I'll see you next time.